By the things of the world. It's easy, Lord, to be distracted by our own anxiety, our own fear.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, it's so easy to be distracted because of the attention that we give to ourselves.
Amen.
But Lord, this morning, help us to turn our eyes, not only our eyes, but our heart, our ears, our our future.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, everything that we just turn it over to you, speak to our hearts this morning.
Yes. Amen.
Say together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Remain standing. Let's sing together. The church is one foundation.
Of our Christian faith.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
God saved him. Should not have made it probably, but I still want prayer. And so, even though we're thankful for seat belts and ailer bags and whatever God did to keep him safe, he is whole, he is home. And but he's going to be a long road to recovery. So keep him in prayer. Cody.
We'll certainly keep him in our prayer. Praise the Lord that he is with us.
Yes.
Yes, amen. Any other praise report? Yes, sir. Praise.
Praise God for the day-to-day blessings.
Amen.
There's things going on and you get a little down and something will happen and it shows himself.
Yes. I like
it. Remind yourself.
Hallelujah.
That's what it's all about right there. Praise
God. I like that, bro. Yeah. He shows himself. I like that. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
I was out doing errands and I, not that I need any fabric or anything else, I need to go to Annie. And I went to Annie, and there was the woman who was buying tatting stuff. I have been wanting to learn how to tat, but haven't. Anyway, we had a nice little conversation, so I met somebody because God said, go to Annie.
Amen. God is so good like that. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, ma'am, in the back. Virginia, would you stay? Well, would you stay? You're already on your feet. What good if you have the experience from the Lord?
First, give honor to God who's ahead of my life. I thank God for being here today. I want to say that I went to the doctor and my report is still clear. And I want to say thank you for every prayer that was given to me, for the support you gave me during the time I went through that surgery. That was the first time in my life that I had went through anything that serious. And I didn't realize how bad it really was until that. The prayers, I just want to say thank you for your prayers. The prayers are bringing me through. God is good.
Amen.
And he's here for us today.
Yes,
all
ma'am.
We need to do is lean and depend on him.
Come on.
And I wanted to tell y'all, you have a wonderful pastor. This man, he called me, he checked on me, he prayed with me. I had others that sent cards. And that really lifted my spirit at the time that I was going through that. some of us have been through surgery, and you, I don't know how you took it, but for me, it was devastating to know that something that bad was happening to me. But God gave me the strength to fight through that. I got in my Bible. I stood on those scriptures where he said he's a God that can heal us.
Go ahead.
Amen.
He said he can lift you up when you're down.
Yes, ma'am.
He can bring you through your troubles. He can show you love. Ooh. And he said all you had to do was lean and depend on him. And no matter what you're going through and no matter how hard the trial may seem, God says, I'm right here. I love you. I see you through.
Hallelujah.
If you just lean on me, I'm right here for you. I'm not far away. And he forgives us for the things we do. All we got to do is tell him.
Amen.
He's not going to hold it against you. He's going to lift you up. He's going to pull you forward and bring you out and say, my child, go ahead. I love you. It's okay. It's taken care of. And I just wanted to stand up and give God the praise and the honor.
Amen. Well, I commend you for raising your hand after that. But go ahead and stand up.
Because you see what we have in this church, and
that's right.
Is come back to church Sunday, so everybody bring somebody and show bring the love to the church.
That's right. That's right. And if you haven't got a ticket yet, we charge you every bit of $1. And that helps us roll the head camp. So picnic. Yes, ma'am. Pray for the homeless issue and keeping you in prayer for a place for your family. Yeah. Amen. We want to pray for that. Yes, sir. Amen. That's good stuff. Yes, and they came from Tennessee. Bless their heart. Yes. Anyone else? Prayer request. Remember R.C. Miller, talked with him this morning. He's actually back in the hospital after he had the pacemaker put in. And he's still having some problems with that. I hear that Miss Gertrude's sister passed away this morning,
last night.
Last night. You would keep that family in your prayer. Mr. Gerald Thurman, if you would keep him in your prayer, in your prayers as well. Him, he is, they called in hospice. And so if you would keep him and the Potter family in your prayer. Yes, ma'am. Right.
But he shared with me, he was so excited. Hospice is there, but he left yesterday and went to his class reunion in Monson, Florida. And he was so excited that he was going to live long enough to go to that place.
Amen. That's good. Brother Gerald we had a great conversation. And Bud and I had prayer with him, and you know, we just said that whatever time you have left, make it to this.
He is.
And he is. And that should be for all of us, right? Because none of us know how long we have. Make the best of it. Yeah, amen. Yes, ma'am. Young lady.
I pray for whoever doesn't have like a grandparent to give something to, for them to have a great day.
That is wonderful. If y'all didn't hear that, she said she prays for everybody that didn't have a grandparent. Because it's a wonderful day, Grandparents Day. So all the grandparents out there, can I put your hands in the air, shake them like you do care. Yeah. Wonderful. Amen. Amen. Prayer request. Who is this?
Penny.
Penny is. Okay. Good.
For her.
Good for her. Yes, sir. Joe lived in the back. Yes.
Pray for my dad. I was out most of last night. He's in a lot of pain. He thinks it's his kidneys.
bless his heart. And hope the kidney stones or whatever it is can be.
His name's Eddie Lee Williams.
Eddie Lee Williams. We will pray for him. Yes, ma'am.
Can you pray for the students in my classroom? I have about five that I know of right now who are homeless.
Bless your heart. Yeah, bless their heart. Bless
them.
Praying for the homeless students in her classroom. And that's a teacher's heart. Yeah. Yes, sir, Mike.
Continue prayers for Brenda's health.
Continue your prayers for Brenda. Yes.
Lift up Richard Ken and Judy. Richard had to go back to the hospital.
That is correct. Thank you for reminding me of that. I talked with Judy late last night. Richard's been in the hospital a couple days. He's having some MRI done today to find out what the problem was, even though she didn't tell me what his symptoms were. We will continue to lift him up in prayer. Yes, Glenn.
Yeah, a close friend of mine, she moved back in the hospital last week. She's still there. Her name is Joanne Lambert. And after my band practiced a little bit, I'm heading to the hospital to see her.
Okay, we'll pray for her.
Bill Brown.
Bill Brown. Let's go to the, yes, ma'am.
Yes, I have a real good friend. She is diagnosed with cancer. She has hospice in and out, but she's got bronchitis. And so.
Bless your heart. What is her name?
Helen Moore. Morris.
Let us pray. Holy God, we come to you, Lord, because. Come unto me, and you'll give us rest. Lord, many of us need rest. Literally, rest in our bodies, rest in our souls, rest in our spirit. So come, Holy Spirit, and may your peace overshadow everyone in this place. We give you thanks and praise, O God, for the wonderful testimonies that we hear, how you've delivered from cancer. How, Lord, you're at work in each individual life. How, Lord, you're helping people recover from car accidents and surgeries. How, Lord, you're at work in mending relationships. And how, Father, you're at work mending our hearts. Lord, for each prayer that's been lifted up this morning, we pray, God, that your grace will cover each and every need. We're confident,
yes,
God,
Lord. Hallelujah.
That, Lord, surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And whether it may be a day, a week, a month, or years, we'll know that eventually we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. This we give you thanks and praise, as people said.
Amen.
I'm going to ask our handsome ushers if they would come, and we're going to receive the offering. Let us pray. Father, again, we give you thanks, and we praise your holy name for all the good gifts, the blessings you pour out into our life. And like our brother said, Lord, just whenever we need you the most, you show up. Bless the offering, that it may continue your work in this church. We ask in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.